Welcome to Haider-Moranis Bulletin. My name is Murtaza Haider.
And I'm Stephen Moranis.
In this episode, we are discussing mortgage pre-approvals, why you must consider applying for one, what does the process look like, and what documentation you will need.
And we'll show you how to polish up your credit score.
Stephen, what is mortgage pre-approval?
It's basically getting a loan approved so you know how much you can buy a house for. And it's best to apply with a bank and try to figure out what kind of financing you can put in place.
How early in the buying process should you apply for a pre-approval?
As early as possible, because it's important if you find a home that you want to purchase and it's a high demand property, you may have to go in unconditional with a firm offer, and it's important to know what kind of financing you have in your pocket before you make that offer.
So in terms of definitions, we hear mortgage pre-approvals and we also hear mortgage pre-qualification. Are they different or the same?
Pre-qualification is more a generic indication of the kind of mortgage loan that you can get, so the amount of loan. The pre-approval is they've done their homework, they've gone back to credit, the money is really set aside for you, subject to you purchasing a home.
Let's look at the application process. You have to apply for a credit loan. What does this credit loan application process look like?
Well, there's a lot of personal information they require. So typically the bank will want to see your T4s, they'll want to see your earnings stubs, they'll want to see your assets and liability. This all sort of takes into account and determines your credit worthiness. And based on that, you'll be approved for the biggest loan possible.
So here's the thing, like if you work full time and you have a regular employment, you get a pay stub, you take it to the bank and the bank can verify it. But you may also be self-employed.
The self-employed individual is a little more tricky, especially with government regulations now. You have to somehow show bank accounts, bank records to prove your credit worthiness.
Is it fair to say that if you are self-employed, you have to do a little bit more in terms of documentation to establish your credit worthiness?
Absolutely, and I think also loan to value may be different. Self-employed tend to not be able to get 75% mortgages. It's more like 50%. So let's say you're buying a house for $500,000. Typically, a self-employed, if they're putting $250,000 down, they'll be less stringent mm-hmm. on you in getting approved, as long as there's 50% equity.
So from this, I would gather that the bigger the down payment, the more likely you are to be approved for the loan.
Absolutely. The more you put down, the better position you are to get a mortgage, and also on better terms, a lower interest rate, and all the other features that a mortgage includes.
There are new ways to apply for mortgage application. Now everybody has got, almost everybody has got a smartphone or smart device. Tell us a little bit about it.
Well, you can go into your bank and speak to a friendly representative. You can do it online. You could probably do it through a call center. And so you can probably drive in front of the house, you see a for sale sign on, sort of go into your device and probably get approved on the spot.
Now, assume that I'm applying for a loan, and then I go through the process and they pre-approve me for an amount. Do you think that is sufficient, or should I shop around and go to other institutions and ask for more, get second opinion as this?
It doesn't hurt to get a couple of opinions, go to a couple of financial institutions and just feel your way through and see who you're most comfortable in dealing with.
Okay, so I applied, I've been pre-approved. Now, is this pre-approval for a 1 day, 1 month, 1 year? How long is the pre-approval for? How long it lasts?
Typically, the pre-approval will be with a rate, which normally is a rate guarantee period, which depends on the bank or financial institution.
So in times of some interest rate volatility, you see rates going up and down, and sometimes, or most of the time, we don't know which direction they will move in. Let's say you got a pre-approval for a certain period of time for a particular rate, and then suddenly things change. Can your lender back out of that pre-approval guarantee?
Typically, no. As long as you've got a pre-approval, it's bona fide, you're fine within the rate guarantee period. So you're pretty safe.
Stephen, things can change. People can lose their job. The mortgage rates that they negotiated for can change. In case of a new job, a raise, or a job loss, should people notify the financial institution?
Absolutely. You should tell them if your circumstances change, because you can always alter the loan amount that you got approval for. So you can lower it or you may increase it based on circumstances.
Should you choose not to buy, would it be a strike against you?
Absolutely not. A mortgage pre-approval sits there. If you don't buy and you don't take the funding, it's really a neutral.
So in terms of documentation, we talked about the income and wealth or down payments. In addition to that, you also have a credit rating and a credit score. Does it have any impact on the rate you can negotiate with your financial institution?
Absolutely. And as we said before, the credit score, we'd like you to polish it up. You should check that in advance. You can do that. There's many ways you can do it online. And it's basically translated into a beacon score. The higher the beacon score, the brighter your credit light is, and you'll be able to get probably a much lower rate from the bank with a higher beacon score. Over 700, over 800. That's sort of the territory you want to be in. It's important to check your credit score because sometimes there's items on your credit report that you took care of, 10 years ago and they're still there. You didn't pay a department store on a $200 bill and it's a flaw in your credit and it's not true and you really have to clear it up.
So what else can we do or people can do to improve their credit score?
You can pay down debts, number one. You can ensure that all your credit card bills and other accounts are paid on a timely basis.
So what are the final takeaways for mortgage pre-approval?
Well, I think our best advice is get at least a couple of pre-approvals so you can compare the terms, the rates, the options, the features. That's an important thing. You must then also put all your financial information together, which includes checking your credit scores, making sure you have all your income statements, your T4s, your notice of assessment from Revenue Canada. These are all important things that you must put in place, and a list of your assets and liability and your net worth.